365 days, one journey of the Earth around the Sun. At whatever time, on whatever day you're watching this right now, you know that the same time and date will come to pass next year, and the year after that, and the one after that, and so on. But what if, actually, that wasn't the case? What would happen if humankind learned that this really was the end times for our planet? This is Unveiled, and today we're answering the extraordinary question, what if the world was ending in 1 year? Do you need the big questions answered? Are you constantly curious? Then why not subscribe to Unveiled for more clips like this one, and ring the bell for more thought-provoking content. Picture the scene. Wherever you are, whatever you're doing, you become aware of sirens blaring out, of breaking news bulletins interrupting TV and the radio, of a sudden onrush of social media notifications, each more panicked than the last, of people rushing to the streets outside, a frenzy of screams and tears, and confused and frightened faces everywhere you turn. The truth has just been revealed. The apocalypse really is upon us. The world will end in 1 year's time. Exactly how such a scenario would ever come to pass is unknown. There are a few possibilities, though. In one, an unstoppable asteroid or rogue planet is spotted racing through the solar system towards us, with enough power to break our little world into tiny fragments. In another, an alien civilization first reveals itself to us, and then, bizarrely, issues us a 1 year notice before they destroy everything we've ever known. In another, some kind of supremely bad human being gains control over the entire planet's nuclear arsenal and sets them all to explode in 52 weeks exactly, for no apparent reason other than the neatness of the plan. We could, then, be imagining some kind of genuinely possible natural and scientific setup, or something more akin to a science fiction fantasy. But nevertheless, what would happen next? What would happen if the global population knew that its time on Earth really was running out? In a purely practical sense, the economy collapses, first of all. Far fewer people are going to turn up for work in a world that's as good as dead. And no one is going to be that interested in buying stuff, especially not for the long term, when the long term isn't even going to happen. If you knew there was only 1 year left until genuine Armageddon, would you bother making the Monday morning commute? Would you diligently continue to pay your rent on time? Not likely. Instead, we, the helpless human beings, would probably switch from doing the things we should do to doing the things we want to do. So, what does that look like for many? The shock and fear over our impending doom would really rob them of the freedom to choose how they feel. All stages of grief would set in, and on a global scale. The collective panic would rise and rise as the few remaining weeks ticked by, which would turn some of us into angry and selfish versions of ourselves, while others might change in the opposite way, becoming more grateful and kind. It's often predicted that in the face of disaster, humans would turn to looting, violence, and chaos. And in some ways, predicted with good reason, desperate times can lead people to acting out of character. But actually, there's evidence to suggest that humanity wouldn't turn ugly. In January 2018, a false alarm was issued across Hawaii, incorrectly warning residents to seek immediate shelter due to an incoming ballistic missile threat. In reality, there was no incoming weapon, and everyone was safe. But, and although the error was righted within just a few minutes, in the short time that people really did think their lives were at risk, there were no reported instances of unsavory behavior. In fact, there were only accounts of people trying to help one another. Based on that case study, it turns out that humanity isn't so bad after all. But of course, today's question is a whole other ballgame. Here, we're not talking about just a few minutes of terrifying uncertainty. We're imagining day after day along a certain road to death. How do you fill that time? Although the global economy will have quickly broken, whole industries could still pop up, seeking to make the best of the moments that are left. Try Before You Die Goods and Services, non-stop pleasure cruises, life after Earth contingency plans. Clearly, the opportunity for scams would be unprecedented, given that there'd be no time or particular desire for policing. But on the other hand, without money in the traditional sense, what could a scammer hope to gain? Perhaps we'd more likely see the emergence of close-knit communities built around like-minded people who all want the same or similar things out of their final days alive. There might be a group of storytellers traveling across North America, for example, or a band of divers congregated at the Great Barrier Reef, a troupe of musicians somewhere, spending their final year playing all their favorite pieces, or a setup of athletes organizing one final Olympic Games. Any and all would be surrounded by animals roaming free, released from farms and zoos, as nature returns to the wild as much as we revert to our instincts. Perhaps no one would feel the need to join together more, however, than the scientists, engineers, and technologists, because they, more than anyone, might believe that the end of the world can be stopped. For this reason, some versions of the internet might remain. Some forms of communication might still work. The needs to coordinate efforts would drive some to try to preserve the connections between us. Because in whatever form the apocalypse were to take, knowing that it is exactly 1 year away would work like the ultimate deadline. A before and after moment beyond anything else. Could science and technology deliver a solution before that deadline came to pass? It's a sure bet that many would try. While some turns to nature and physics, however, others would turn to God. The world's religions will have encountered perhaps their most trying time in history. Those dedicated preachers who remain loyal to their cause would now be tasked with navigating their followers through the world's end. Armageddon wouldn't only be a looming threat on the horizon anymore, it would be there, happening, in front of everyone's eyes. Would faith in the rapture be enough to see them through? Would the image of heaven remain strong? Would tensions break out between those who believe and those who don't, or between those who believe one thing and those who believe another? This would be religion's ultimate test. More broadly, how does the picture change as we move into the final month? If it were an asteroid strike that was coming, then that fatal rock might now be visible in the sky. If it were some kind of alien attack, perhaps the ship is hovering over us. By now, Earth and human civilization could be a very different place. Ruin will have already started to set in, given all of the upheaval of the 11 months before. If there are people still frantically working to try and stop what's to come, then their numbers will likely have dwindled. Their scope will likely have narrowed, and whatever communication links might have remained between them will probably have failed. Likewise, all over the map, it could be as though the world were shutting down, eking out its final pangs of energy before the screen goes blank. Now is the time to tell people you love them, to rebuild bridges with friends you regret losing, and to, finally, cut yourself some slack too. Given the immense hardships that will have unfolded since our date with destiny was signed, the unfortunate reality is that the global population will have already dropped. By this point, food would be low, clean water would be scarce, energy and warmth would be difficult to come by. Homes and shelters would still stand, but as hollowed out husks of what they once were. Other buildings, like offices, train stations, museums, and schools, would be abandoned, or else will have been fortified in one last desperate bid to kick against the inevitable. What do you think you'd be doing with 1 month left to go? How about 1 week? On the final day, there's really no telling what Earth would feel or look like, but what remains of humankind would be united under this single, monumental, and inescapable event. Families might gather together as one. Friends might spend their last moments having one final catch-up. Or the end of all things might actually be an entirely lonely place with only your own thoughts for company. You will have made it to the final showdown, and so you look up to the sky and wait. And that's what would happen if the world were ending in 1 year.
What do you think? Is there anything we missed? Let us know in the comments. Check out these other clips from Unveiled, and make sure you subscribe and ring the bell for our latest content.